now the first thing is kita nak buat dia punya laksam ya. So here I have around 500 gram of rice flour or tepung beras ya. So this one I can get in Asian market here is a rice flour, so I'm going to put here in the bowl like this. And then here I have here is about 2 tablespoon or 2 sudu besar of plain flour. Plain flour put here as well. And then is I use around 1 liter of cold water first, yeah. So now I have to little bit stir. This is I need another 500 ml. Okay, now it's a 1 liter cold water. Okay, now stir. Okay, before we put the hot water, okay. So now I'm going to put another 1 more liter of hot water, yeah. Like this. So now we have stir the mixture like this until sampai dia mix lah. Okay, like this. So now we start cooking. Okay, now we steam the laksam. Now first we have to put the pinggan plastik dalam ni dengan minyak ya. So bagi dia panas sikit sekejap. Okay, now okay, the pinggan pun dah panas. So I'm going to put the mixture dalam ni. So one portion only one ladder ya. Like this. Macam ni. A bit more. Okay, after that I going to steam for 5 minutes. Okay. Okay, now over 5 minutes now. We will check. Okay, I think should be okay now. If you want to see dia masak ke tak, make sure the mixture is bubbling like this ya, macam ni. So kita terus rollkan dia. Macam ni rollkan dia. Macam kita roll okay, like this. See that? After that, straight away after roll, straight away we put here. Boom. Voila. Okay. Okay, after that is I have here is around 2 kilo of blue mackerel fish fillet, yeah. So this is not a whole fish. This is a fillet, already fillet, is no bone here. So kita kena boilkan ikan ni sampai ikan ni overcook and masak, okay. So make sure we need more water here actually. So the reason is I use a mackerel fillet here because I cannot get the whole one, because only that mackerel, only this yang I ada. So I guna yang ni dulu lah. So we need more water here. Okay, after that we going to put is around 3 or 4 of tamarind. Okay, now let the boil lah. Okay, I think the fish is ready now. So now we turn off the fire. We turn off the heat lah, tutup api. So now we going to blend the fish ya. Okay, now before that we have to blend the shallot lah. This is around 10 numbers of a shallot I slice. So I'm going to put here in the blender machine. And as well it's around 2 inches of sliced ginger. Okay, now this is water from the boil the fish just now, so I'm going to put here. Boom. Okay, now we blend that, yeah. So make sure it's very very fine, very very smooth like this. Why? Okay now, so I'm going to put this one, all the blend item in the pot like this. Voila. Okay, now we have to blend the fish, yeah. So this one I said to you is easy. I use the mackerel fillet like this. I don't need to debone. Use my hand and peel one by one. So like this, that means it's much more easy, much more safe time with me. So I'm going to put here. I'm going to blend, make sure is betul-betul hancur ya, betul-betul smooth. So guna air yang sama, masuk sini. dengan benda air paip. Masuk air ni balik. And kita pelan sekali. Okay now, straight away masuk dalam pot tadi balik.
Boom.
This. Okay now we put back in the stove. We put in back in the pot like this. So now I going to put together is around 800 ml. Oh sorry, the 400 ml first the coconut milk. Yeah. Like this inside. Boom. I don't have a fresh coconut milk. I have only the canned one, so that is another one more thing is all together about 800 ml coconut milk. Yeah. So gunakan dia punya kepala saja, santan pekat. Ya, kalau yang dalam tin tu, okay. So dia punya ju air dia tu kita buang lah, okay. So I going to put another two more of dry tamarind. Okay, now make sure it's low fire, it's late they're boiling. Yeah. So it's actually it's more longer your boiling is more better, but we have to be low heat, otherwise the santan will be pecah minyak, yeah, will be split the coconut milk, so not nice. So you have to stir time every time like this, okay? Okay. At the same time, I going to put about 30 gram of shrimp paste. The shrimp paste I mix with the water, yeah, before I put in like this. So now keep it stirring, otherwise your coconut milk will be split. Okay, akan pecah minyak. Okay, now we can see the sauce or laksa gravy sudah pun menggelegak, dah boiling macam ni. Okay, and the master key is we have to put black pepper, yeah, black pepper powder. I going to put around 1 teaspoon black pepper powder. And we seasoning with the salt. Now, and now we keep stirring. Okay, sampai dia betul-betul orang kata sebati lah. Macam ni. And this one is like all the foam here we have to skip off. Okay. Okay, now is a laksa gravy is ready. So now I'm going to turn off the heat. Yeah. So now I'm going to do the sambal, yeah. So the first thing is this is a fresh chili. Boom in. And some that is a dry chili, yeah. I already blend or blanch. Boom. And some belacan. So now kita kasih tumbuk dia. Okay. Same like you do the sambal belacan. Exactly the same. But this one, original recipe is normally they use dry chili is like this, macam ni lah. Kan setengah orang dia tak pakai dry chili pun, dia pakai chili fresh. And be careful lah bila you tumbuk ni, kena jaga hati-hati sikit. Kalau masuk mata, I think you going to wash your face until sahur tomorrow morning. That is for sure. So you need grind them, the grind the chili ni sampai the mash macam ni, okay, sampai dia jadi paste. Okay, after that you have to put some lime juice, little bit press lime juice here. Make sure tumbuk dulu cili tu sampai dia hancur, baru bubuh lime juice. Kalau tidak dia berair, cili tu akan merekik masuk mata. Sendiri mau ingat. Okay, so now macam ni saja. So just mix them like that. And I no need to put any salt anymore because of sharing paste or belacan dah termasin. So now this is, I want to show you this is look like, yeah. Okay, now it's a laksam already, also condiment also ready as well. Is I have here is a bean sprout, I have a red onion, I have a sambal just now, the chili I show you, and also the here is a some long bean or fine bean, and also some lime. So now I going to show you how to presentation or how to serve, yeah. Okay, the first thing is a laksam. We have to scissor them. Okay, like this. Normally the people is do the slanting like this. Okay. use a scissor.
Voila.
Disconnect. Depend on you how thick you want, but myself I prefer is more thick, is more nicer. So this is a look like, yeah. Okay. So I going to put I think one portion at least two roll for this. Alright, now it's ready. Okay, now is laksa already sliced like this. So see, must be look like they did. Nampak macam ni after I slice. So now I going to put the sauce first. Okay. Especially who Kelantan people, dia tahu makan laksa ni sebenarnya kuah tak banyak. Okay, sebab most of them makan gunakan tangan, ya. Okay, laksa ni sebenarnya makan guna tangan, dia tak guna pakai fork and spoon. Okay, this. Okay, put the sauce. Voila. And some bean sprout. Okay, bean sprout little bit. Some red onion, some long bean, voila, and then this is a lime, fresh lime, and the last is sambal or chili. I'm going to put in the middle like this, voila. And also I have here is a kasum leaf. I don't have fresh one, so I need to put here as well. So this is a look like. This is our laksam for today, yeah. So I hope everybody can try this. Okay, bye.